Assalamu alaikum, students. I hope you are fine and ready to participate in this learning activity. First of all, let me give you the feedback on the work that you did last week. All the work, most of you performed very well, and I have checked the work and returned it to you. But please, whenever you receive any worksheet, make it sure it is complete. Some of you attempted only 30 sentences because unfortunately there was a gap in between 30 and 31. And therefore, please in future be a bit careful. Now, the kind of mistakes some of you made, they were mainly related to collective nouns or class nouns. And I made it very clear to you that class noun or collective noun can take singular verb as well as plural verb. If we take the class noun as a whole, as a unit, as a entity, one entity, then it is singular. But when we take the individuals into account, but here I would like to give you one simple, very useful tip. Whenever the members of a class noun are doing something, it is generally plural. And I also made it very clear to you that whenever we talk about the police, it is plural, not the organization, but a contingent of a few policemen. Okay? Then please, today you will be given or sent a worksheet on reading comprehension. It is one of the difficult passages, let me make it clear to you, but please, it is passage 2, narrative. It is passage 2, reading for meaning. Read it very carefully. If you have any question regarding the passage you are going to be sent today, you may ask me questions when tomorrow we have question time or session. Okay. Now, one more thing. Tomorrow, inshallah, we are going to talk about how to build the plot of a story. Okay? There will be a few questions which have been in the past papers, and I'll be talking about how to develop a plot from your experience. And again, English teachers talk about reading exposure, and that is very, very crucial. Please do read every day, whatever you like, okay? Now please come back to this worksheet, these confusing words, vocabulary list. Many of the words are a bit confusing. Actually, these words are continuation of the previous worksheet that we did last week. Now please, appraise. When we use the word appraise, it means to evaluate, to judge, to estimate. For example, we have appraisal of our property. Maybe you want to sell your house and you want to know its price. Or you will be getting its appraisal. But this is also used, for example, unfortunately, if there is a car accident, you take the car to a workshop and you want to know how much is going to be spent on rebuilding the car. So that will be the appraisal. Appraisal means judge, estimate, evaluate. But the other word here, apprise. Apprise just means to inform. All the concerned parties have been apprised about the next meeting. It means they have been communicated, they have been informed. Then the word is apprehend. When we use the word apprehend, it means to fear, to doubt or to have fear. And from apprehend, the word noun is derived apprehension. And I think this word will appear in the worksheet that you will get today. Apprehension. Apprehend, fear. But comprehend means to understand. I couldn't comprehend what he wanted to convey. It means to understand. The word, first word, artist is a very common word. Artist can be a painter, somebody who does some creative work, artist. Maybe in the play, actors are generally referred to as artists. But please, this word, with an extra E, is first of all pronounced as artiste. Okay? The word is pronounced as artiste, and it means a public performer, a dancer, or a singer. Somebody who performs in public is an artiste. Assent, and consent. This word is derived from ascend, opposite of descend. Ascent means when the surface rises, goes upwards, angularly. For example, our car broke down when the ascent of Murray started. It means when we were going up. But these words, these two words are closely related. Basically, these two words mean agreement, willingness of a person. For example, my parents readily assented to my plan of studying abroad. Assent. Consent. Once again, it means willingness. But there is some difference in both the words. In these two words, there is a very subtle difference. What is the difference? If the willingness is given readily, without any objection, without any hesitation, without any reservations, then we use the word assent. If somebody agrees happily, without any objection, without any reservation, we use the word assent. And consent. Consent is agreement. But if somebody consents, he or she may have some reservations, some objections, but the person agrees. For example, at first he was not ready to go along with us, but then she consented. It means after thinking over it, she agreed. Attention. This word needs to be explained. Intention means purpose. I didn't want to hurt him. I had good intentions. Intention means your purpose. You are familiar with this word. Oral means verbal. We have received oral invitation to attend the party. The word also means related to mouth. For example, if a doctor is prescribing you a medicine, he may say or warn you, this medicine is only for oral use, that you can swallow it, but you cannot apply it anywhere else, okay? But this oral means related to hearing. For example, in our language lab, we use many oral aids. For example, if somebody has bad hearing, somebody is hard of hearing, you know, elderly people, they have problems later in life with their hearing. So they use hearing aids, small, you may say, devices which are used near the ears, and sometimes they are fixed, sometimes they are visible, sometimes they are not visible. So you may say, some elderly people who have hearing problem, they use oral aids. Averse. If you are averse to something, you hate it, you dislike it. Most elderly people are averse to fast food. This is one of the facts. Many parents, grandparents, they do not like the eating preferences of younger people or your liking or preferences. Averse. Adverse means hostile, negative, opposing. They are living in adverse conditions. The weather these days is adverse. It means very negative. He was very upset at the adverse comments of the teacher on his assignment. It means negative comments. Avocation. This word may be new to some of you. Vocation. Vocation is a common word. Vocation means profession, somebody's profession. My mother is a dentist by vocation. Vocation means profession. And this word is avocation. Avocation is something that you do for your entertainment, a kind of hobby or pastime. So this is my avocation. Baleful. Baleful means full of hatred. Full of hatred. He gave his enemy a baleful look. It means which was full of hatred, dislike. And baneful, Painful is used in situations when something has an evil, negative, bad influence on somebody. Painful. Those of you who have read the story of Macbeth by William Shakespeare, they know that Lady Macbeth had a baneful influence on her husband. Baneful means evil. Beneficent, kind. Beneficent. Allah is the most merciful and beneficent. But this word, beneficial, profitable. If something is beneficial, it is helpful, favorable, profitable. Okay? Then we come to this word, beside. Beside means by the side of. He was sitting beside his mother. Okay? And the word besides means moreover, in addition. Besides the principal, many visitors also address the students. So besides means in addition, moreover. Then bridal, bridal. Both these words are pronounced in the same way, bridal. Okay? This word has to do something with the bride. For example, the bridal dress, the bridal jewelry. Okay? Cost. There can be so many derivatives, bridal. But this bridal is a pair of straps, generally made of leather, in order to ride an animal, especially a horse. And we also use this word metaphorically in idioms. For example, you might have heard somebody say or reprimand you, scold you, please bridle your tongue. It means control. If somebody is talking very loosely, the parent may criticize or may be angry with him or her, and this word may be used. Please bridle your tongue. But if this word is used unbridled, it means without any control, without any check. He kept on talking unbridled, without any check, without any stop. Canon. Very common word, canons of Islam. It means principles of Islam. This canon, a kind of weapon, a kind of gun, cannons were firing in the battlefield. Okay? Canvas. This is the first one with single S, is a kind of rough cloth. Generally, it is used either in making, you may say, waterproof articles, sometimes even shoes. Canvas shoes are very popular with young people. And this canvas is used generally regarding elections, when people, you may say, argue to vote in favor of their candidate. Okay, you may say canvassing was not allowed in the premises. This caste is to throw caste, broad caste. And you might have read or heard the idiom, caste pearls before swine. Okay? Caste pearls before swine. And this is, you may say, discriminatory system. Generally, in India and Pakistan, family system. For example, generally we say, in India, they have a very strong caste system, but Islam does not believe in any caste system. The word, the first word is casual. Casual means when, for example, many young people love to dress casually. They were in casual dress. He was talking casually. It means not carefully, not formally. Casual actually is the opposite of formal. Then this word is causal. This word is derived from cause. Cause means reason. Okay. For example, we may say happiness in life has causal relationship with achievement, sense of being loved. It means it is interrelated, causal. Then this sees is stop. Ceasefire. At last, a ceasefire was announced that both the fighting parties stopped fighting. And this cease is to hold something firmly, tightly. Cease. Seizures, you might have heard this. Somebody has seizures, and especially for boys, you might use this word, the engine of the car has been seized. When the engine stops working, we say it has been seized. When it is jammed, okay? Censure. Criticize, scold. Basically, these words are synonyms, and one word you will see in your reading comprehension that you are going to be sent today, and that is reprimand. Now, you have four words for scolding somebody. One, censure, criticize, scold, reprimand. There are actually some other words as well. Ceremonial. Ceremonial is related to ceremony. If any, for example, the ceremonial dinner related to ceremony. The happy ceremonial was over. But ceremonious means when somebody's behavior is too formal. And you know, most of us feel very uncomfortable when somebody is being very ceremonious. Ceremonious means very formal, or you may say unusually formal, childish, very useful words, childlike. Now please listen. If somebody is childish, it is a negative word. It is a, when we say somebody is childish, it is not a compliment, it is criticism. Okay, somebody who is elderly, who is young, who is adult, is behaving like a child. Foolish. It has the meaning of foolishness. But childlike is a compliment. Somebody who is elderly, who is adult, who is grown up, if he or she is attributed to be childlike, it means the person is simple and innocent. So, childlike, innocent, a compliment. Childish, foolish, not a compliment. Cloth. Cloths and clothes. Now please listen. Cloth is the raw material. Generally, cloth which is wrapped in rolls, which when you go to a shop to buy some cloth for your dress, it will be in rolls, okay? And to make it simple, unsewn cloth is this. And cloths, please, one more clarification. This cloth is uncountable. Okay, for example, if you go to a fabric shop, this cloth is uncountable. This cloth is countable, but the meaning is different. When we use this word as countable noun, cloths, it means pieces of cloth that are used for some specific, special purpose. For example, in your kitchen, your mother may have so many pieces of cloth which are used for handling hot pans, for cleaning, or for scrubbing, or something else. But what you have to remember is, if a piece of cloth is used for some special purpose, it becomes countable. Then, sight. Sight, first one, means to mention. He cited many Quranic verses in his speech. This site is the workplace. This site is the vision or the scene, etc. You don't need to be coma. Coma is a medical condition when somebody is inactive physically. After the shock, he went into a coma. And this is grammatical term, comma, a punctuation mark, command, order. He commanded authority. Commend, appreciate. His work was commended by his boss. Common, actually, please, this word needs to be explained. Mutual means two-way. And many of you are very familiar with this word. You have so many mutual friends. But please do remember, a mutual friend cannot be a common, may not be a common friend. Mutual, for example, generally we say, true friendship depends on mutual respect. It means, which is two-way. Then, compliment, appreciation. Please convey my compliments to him. Okay. This compliment means something which completes something else. Koi problem to nahi hai if I finish it. Now please listen. Compose and comprise. If something is made up of different parts, members, etc., we use the word compose. Consist is another word, and made up is another word. But they have the same meaning, but their use is different. For example, water is composed of hydrogen and oxygen, clear? Water comprises hydrogen and oxygen. The only difference between compose and comprise is comprise does not take off, no preposition. Compose takes off, OF. Confident and confident. Please listen. Confident is an adjective. He was very confident about his position, his ability, but this confident means somebody you trust. Somebody you trust. He was betrayed by his own confident. It means the person he trusted the most. Conscious. The word conscious means aware. But conscious also means when you are in your senses. You go to a hospital to visit somebody who is sick, and the nurse over there, our attendant over there, he or she stops you. The patient is still not conscious. It means he has still not regained his senses. Okay? But conscious also means know, aware. Are you conscious of the blunders you have made? That do you have realization? Do you know them? Okay. And conscience, the word is conscience. Conscience is your inner self. The inner self which tells you the difference between the right and wrong. For example, there are so many people who say that they are there is burden on their conscience. For example, If you do something against your heart, it means you are doing it against your conscience. Conscience, in a nutshell, means your inner self. There is another word, conscientious. If somebody is very careful, morally very strong, we say he or she is a very conscientious person. But look at the spelling. Be careful about the spelling. Contagious. If a disease is contagious, it spreads through contact. Through contact. Tuberculosis. There are so many other diseases which spread through contact. And infectious is a disease which spreads through germs. The disease which spreads through airborne germs. Infectious. For example, we say influenza is an infectious disease. Thank you very much, please. Be ready for the reading comprehension today, and please try to submit it in a couple of days so that I can check it. Thanks a lot.